hear the rolling thunder.
The church is a place where the truth might be preached.
Are you with me? So God is counting on you and on me. Is it left you to know who you are in Christ Jesus? God is counting on you this afternoon. And I'm here to reveal the revelation about who you are in God. Now we are coming to the point that I started. The three things that we have, the God, the life, and the life of men. Amen. Now, the Bible says that I agree with the Bible that I was studying today in Proverbs chapter 8, verse 27 and 23, that we were there when God was creating the heavens and the earth. But let us see, if we were there and God had created us today, who are we in the eyes of God? Who are you in the eyes of God? When we let us know. Psalm 82 verse 6. Now we are going to the God. Then we come to the life. Then we come to the life of man. Amen.
Amen. Psalm 82 verse 6. Mm-hmm. I said, you are God.
I said, you are God. No, wait for me. When the Bible says you are God, it means that you carry the power of God. You are not the spirit of God, is a spirit. Amen. And the spirit of God, if it dwells in you, that means you are God. That means you have the power to speak. That things have to happen. Amen. Because God said you were in Him. You were in God. But God kept you within Him until the point in time that He needed you to come forth and speak forth. Hallelujah. That's why the time that you were born, He counted you as a God. So you are God. It means that at this dispensation, He is counting on you to see yourself that you are a God image, that you have the power to speak. For the darkness cover the surface of the earth shall wipe out, so that light shall shine upon the surface of the earth. Amen. Amen. So coronavirus has no power over us. If only you believe that you have Christ and you have the image of God, the spirit of God, that we don't need to speak at this moment. It dwells in you. And you can see that you are God. If you don't know me, I see myself as a God. Because the power of God is in me.